All right. Hey guys, had to redo the video because I realized that I had it, vertical instead of horizontal, and we wanted to make sure we had it horizontal, so when we upload it later on YouTube and things like that, it's the way that we prefer it, so you guys can view it properly. How you guys doing? I think that's Coco jumping on. How y'all doing, man? I'll wait 60 seconds for people to jump on, but this is Tony Perez with Truth. Thanks for joining us, and man, it's a good day. So excited to I'm in a very calm mood, but I'm excited on the inside, amen? So it's good to see you guys, and tonight, Tim will not be with us tonight. If you guys can lift Tim up in prayer, he's just spending some time with the Lord, but just lift him up in prayer. Lift their family up in prayer, just so that they can just rest in the Lord and just seek the Lord, and they're just in this time of rest. So just want to lift him up as he spends time with Father God and the family. And so let's just do that. If the Lord puts him on your heart, just lift him up, and I and the family, of course. And we appreciate that. So how y'all doing, man? How's everybody doing? I want to hear some praise reports. I want to hear just what's been going on in your life. If you guys want to share some things, go ahead. And but today we're going to talk about faith. So we did the fruits of the Spirit. We're doing the fruits of the Spirit. And the first one we did last week was on hope. And if you remember, we did hope, and it was Tim and I and also Christian. And Christian was sharing his testimony and what God had just did. I mean, he grew up in church all his life, and then he just got hit with the presence of God. So that was very awesome that he, you know, had that experience with the Lord. I'm just going to go online here and see if I could share it. If you guys could take a moment and share it, that would be great. So he had that experience with the Lord just a little over 2 months ago, and he's just been hit with the presence of God, and that is just awesome, you know. And I want to, just because that was said, I want to remind everybody, just because you may not have an experience like me or Christian or Tim or anybody else that you've heard, that doesn't mean you have to have the same experience. We all have different experiences with the Lord. The thing that matters the most is that we seek after him, we chase after him, amen? But thanks for sharing, and let's just dive right in. I'm trying to get to the video here so I can share it as well real quick. So just bear with me as I do that. So anybody got a shout out? Anybody gonna say, what's up? Let me see. Faith White. I'm not sure. I wonder if my comment, maybe it's my comment's not. Oh, there it is. My bad. I didn't see the comments. I didn't have it swiped over. What's up, Paula? Hi again. I see you, Ro. I see you, Bug. Thanks for jumping on. Hi, Faith. Nice to meet you. This might be your first time. I don't recognize you, but that's awesome. Well, how awesome is that, Faith White? That we're going to talk on the fruit of the Spirit, faith, and you're here to join us. If you have something you want to add in the comments, feel free to do so. That's awesome. Sorry, guys, I didn't see your comments. Let's see. Let me share this in a group. So, everybody's doing well? Everybody's doing well out there? Love to hear from you guys. Now that I got the comments set up, I'll definitely see when you guys are saying something. So, that's good. I was like, man, I know people are watching, but I don't see any comments. Let's see, share in a group. Yep, just a couple more real quick, and then I'll get us started. Sorry guys for that. It's a little harder with one person because you're trying to do the one while talking and keep it going. But yeah, I want to definitely hear from you guys today. I want to hopefully hear any kind of maybe praise reports, what God is pulling you out of right now, just whatever it is. All right, Rose says, hey, Paula, the Lord allowed me to pray with so many people today, and hallelujah, lead someone to Jesus. Yes, we have another brother or sister in the kingdom. Awesome job, Paula. Praise God, all glory to our King. That is awesome, Paula. Thank you for being so diligent and not growing weary. And that is just great. That is just great to hear. All right, I'm gonna do this last one here. Actually, one more. Kind of hit the top three or four groups that I usually share with, so I figure I'll at least send it to those, and then I'll stop. Boom, boom, boom. United Online Christian Fellowship. That's the one. All right, man. Praise God. All right, let's get on this thing. Let me shut this off, and actually, this might help for the comments on that one, so I'll keep that there. So awesome, man. That is great, Paula. I'm so glad to hear that. All right, let's open up in a word of prayer. Father God, we just thank you for who you are, for your goodness, for your faithfulness. Holy Spirit, you are invited here. Holy Spirit, we see you as a person. Jesus calls you a he, a him. You are a person. So Holy Spirit, come. Holy Spirit, you are here. Testifying the blood of Jesus. That's what you're here for. Be our comforter, be our advocate, be our remembrance of the scriptures. We love you. We love you, Abba Father. We love you, Brother Jesus. And we love you, Holy Spirit. Help me. Holy Spirit, help me. Bring to my remembrance scriptures that are deep down in my heart, Father. For I'm a living epistle, Lord. Just as everybody else online is watching, they're living epistles. If they believe in Jesus, they are living epistles. Bring to our remembrance scripture that is in our heart. Help us share. Help us encourage one another and love one another. Inspire one another into good works, for the kingdom of God is at hand. We thank you, Lord. You're beautiful, you're awesome, you're mighty, you are love, and we are loved by you. We thank you for what you're about to teach us and show us and lead us into today. We give you all glory, all praise. In Jesus' name we pray. And the saints say, amen. Renee, what's up? Roland, what's up? The Citrons are representing. Watch out. Watch out. Don't mess with the Citrons. Yeah, it's good to see you guys. God bless you guys in Cali. And I pray that all is going well over there. JJ, what's up? I see you. And I see you, JJ. Good to see you, brother. Hope you're doing well. And man, let's just get right into it, man. Let's get right into it. Lydia, I see you. God bless you, sis. How's everything going with you? Feel free to share. If there's any questions that you guys have or things you're struggling with, obviously put it on there so that we can all see it and we can all help one another. Amen. So today, you guys can hear me fine. I want to make sure because I'm not using my headphones. Usually through the phone, it's actually really, really good, but I just want to make sure. So if you guys cannot hear me, you just let me know. Again, Tim won't be on tonight, and he's just spending time with the Lord, and so I'm jumping on today, and equipping us and encouraging us all, and you guys encourage me, so praise God, let's do this all for His glory, amen. Kayla, is that you? No, that must be my mom. Maybe my mom has that as her profile. I think that's what it is. She's got a picture of my daughter as her profile. So anyways, faith. When you guys hear faith, what do you think of? I'll throw that out to you first off, and I'll keep speaking as you guys continue to write. But when you hear the word faith, what is the first thing you think of? Is there a memory tied to it, or what do you see faith as? Obviously, our faith should be in the Lord. But when you hear the word faith, what do you think of? What do you see? Please share. What's up, Bug? Oh, it's the Bugs. It's the Bugs profile. He's got my daughter, Kayla. I got you. I'm your Huckleberry. I got you. It looks like, yeah, I just wanted to make sure. Yep, I got Wi-Fi on. Okay. Sorry, guys. K, can hear you great. I think my feed is wiggy though, not seeing everyone. Oh man, yeah, that happens. I think that's actually more like Facebook. It's more of a Facebook thing. So if everybody that's on at least do a thumbs up or a comment, then at least everybody else can see who's on and kind of join in, and that'll help one another. So so I'll give you guys a few seconds there to respond on faith, because what I'm going to do right now is I'm actually going to look up the Hebrew word for faith and see what that means, so we can just kind of dive in and see what faith is in that sense. When I hear faith, I hear promises of God. Wow, that's awesome. When I hear faith, promises of God. Wow, that's great. That is great. Wow, that's really good, because you'll see how that ties in, Paula, with the Hebrew word for faith. So that is fantastic. Bethan. Yeah, Bethan is on. See, I didn't see her on, but she did the thumbs up. Now I see her. So that's awesome. Thank you guys for doing that. We appreciate it, just so we can all see one another and respond to one another. Sorry for the background noise. It looks like I'm not sure what that is. I guess that bird is praising God. It died down. So we got the Hebrew word for faith, and I'm going to look that up. But the scripture I saw here is, because what I think of, one of the scriptures I think of too, is the righteous shall live by faith. The righteous shall live by faith. And that's found in Habakkuk 2:4. And maybe somebody could post that when you get a chance, so I don't leave the feed on here. But Habakkuk 2:4. Is what we want to look at, that the righteous shall live by faith. And I actually can pull it up on this one on my computer here as well. A couple other scriptures. I'm just going to kind of blast out a few scriptures while everybody writes what faith means to them. Ephesians 2:8, for by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is a gift of God. Awesome. For by grace. Paula, we have to know all his promises, and yes and amen, need to have faith for that. Wow. Praise God, Paula. Absolutely. Absolutely. So I feel like I should read the Hebrew word. Instead of reading these scriptures right now, we'll probably go back to that. So let me go right in and go with the Hebrew word. So the Hebrew word for faith is emuna. Hopefully I'm pronouncing that right. I didn't get to hear it before I went live. But it's emuna, emuna, E-M-U-N-A-H, emuna. And here's what it is. The Hebrew word for faith, emuna, and is an action-oriented, it's an action-oriented word meaning support. Isn't that something? An action-oriented word meaning support. This is important because the Western concept of the word faith places the action on the one you have faith in, such as I have quote unquote faith in God. But the Hebrew word emuna places the action on the one who supports God. So it is not a knowing that God will act, but rather I will do what I can to support God. The idea of support for the word emuna can be seen in Exodus 17:12. What's up, Dustin? Good to see you, brother. Maybe I'll have Dustin jump on with me here in a few minutes. Let's read Exodus 17:12. But Moses' hands grew weary, so they took a stone and put it under him, and he sat upon it, and Aaron and Hur held up his hands, one on one side, one on the other, so his hands were steady. Emuna, which is faith in Hebrew, until the going down of the sun, meaning support. So the brothers, Aaron and Hur, came to Moses' aid in faith to support Moses. Isn't that awesome? To support. Love y'all. I'll have to watch later. All right, Dustin, no problem. Celebrate that anniversary, brother. God bless you, bro. Enjoy it. God bless. Thanks for jumping on, and we love you, bro. So did you guys hear that? Is that not amazing? I've never heard this because I've never looked it up, and the Lord was telling me, look up faith in Hebrew. So I was like, all right, let me look up faith in Hebrew. Emuna, faith in Hebrew, faith, emuna. An action-oriented word meaning support. Meaning to support. So instead of looking at it as faith in God, which in the Western world, that's how we would see it. We would see it as an action word on the one. It says the Western concept of faith places the action on the one you have faith in, such as faith in God. But the Hebrew word places the action on the one who supports God. So isn't that something? On the one who supports God. So it's not knowing that God will act, but rather I will do what I can to support God. I just think that's amazing, because what we're doing is we're tying our faith to Him. He's already faithful. We already know He's faithful. So He's saying, will you put your faith into Me and support Me? Because in supporting our faith, putting our faith in Him, and He supports it, He just throws it back at us. Isn't it something that in Scripture, it says that He gave us all a measure of faith? So He gave us all a measure of faith to respond out of. And then we take that measure of faith and use it to support Him, to support His faithfulness. Meaning that, yes, faith, an action-oriented word meaning support. So it was cool how you were seeing what you wrote earlier, Paul. I would have to go back to see how you wrote it. Yes, in His promises. Because isn't that something? If we put our faith, our support in God, our faith is in God, our support is in God, what we're saying is we are taking God at His word. And His word, He's faithful. And His word, He's got promises for us. So when we place our faith, thank you, Jesus, when we place our faith, the measure of faith that He gave us in the first place, when we place that solely into Him, and we put our faith and trust into Him, we are only supporting what He already gave us. So we're basically giving to Him what He gave to us, and in doing so, He gives back to us. You see what I'm saying? It's reciprocal. It keeps coming back. And I just think it's amazing, this word, support. I mean, we are supporting God of who He is, and He is obviously supporting us of who we are in Him. It just puts life into the scripture of, you know, Jesus, I abide in you and you abide in Me. And it just puts even more emphasis on that, and what that, it brings more life to that. Now that we're understanding this word faith, emuna, meaning to support God with our faith, with His. I mean, I just think that's absolutely awesome. Like I said, just seeing this for the first time as far as support. Let's see. It is the support, emuna, of Aaron and Hur that held Moses' arms, not the support of Moses, emuna of Moses. When we say, I have faith in God, we should be thinking, Jesus. When we say, I have faith in God, we should be thinking, I will do what I can to support God. Wow. When we say, I have faith in God, the way we should be thinking that, the Hebrew way of thinking for that, of emuna, I will do what I can to support God in this. This just changes everything. It really does with this type of thinking, because sometimes it's hard for people to grasp, man, I'm trying to have faith in God, man. I'm trying to put my faith and trust in God, but man, He's not answering me, and I just don't see anything changing. And it's like, this is what the Greek word will do, or the Western concept of the word faith, always places the emphasis on the other person, like faith in God. So we're putting the emphasis on God to do something. And so many times we forget that God has already done something. Jesus. God has spoke. God has sent his son. And then through his son, God gave us the comforter, the Holy Spirit. So God has already done everything that he's going to do. Everything that he has spoken, it is out there, it is written. And now it's time for us to attach our faith to his faithfulness and believe what he's done. Believe the promises. Like Paul has said, believe that it's yes and amen. Put our faith in the finished work of Christ Jesus our Lord. And in that, we are actually operating in faith. I mean, wow. Thank you, Lord. I mean, I'm already seeing something else, how this is going to help me personally. And it'll help all of you personally, understanding this word faith in Hebrew. I will do what I can to support God. So now check this out. When we go out and we're at work and we're out grocery shopping and we see somebody in need, or we just see somebody and we just want to go to them. Well, now I don't feel like I have to perform. I don't feel like I have to do something. I don't feel like I have to be led. No, now I'm thinking, wow, I'm going to take this measure of faith that God gave me, all right, that God gave all of you, that God gave all of us. What are we going to do with that measure of faith? Okay? And now we change our thinking. All right, I got to muster up some faith so I can go over there and preach the gospel. I got to muster up enough faith to lay hands on the sick and maybe have them be healed. I got to step out. I got to do this. I got to do that. Now that we're changing our perspective on the word faith, and now we're thinking, I will do what I can to support God in this matter. So now I'm taking this measure of faith. All right, Lord, thank you. Thank you that you've given me this measure of faith, Lord. I see this person across the street, Father God, and I'm just going to go to them because you love them the same way you love me. And Father God, who am I to not support you in who you are? Jesus. Who am I to withhold love? Who am I to withhold grace? Who am I to withhold mercy? Who am I to withhold forgiveness to that person across the street? Who am I? For I am merely a child of God. For I'm merely your son, Lord. So how can I support you in your faithfulness? Because in your faithfulness, you extended so much love upon me. You extended so much grace upon me. You extended so much mercy upon me. You extended so much forgiveness upon me. So the least I can do is use the measure of faith that you've bestowed upon me and support you. Wow. This Hebrew word is just gonna change. This is a game changer. This is gonna be a game changer for us in the faith. This is gonna be a game changer. Because now it's not, and we always say this here on Truth, that it's not about us doing. It's not about us striving, but it's about us being. But now we have a better understanding of this word faith, that it is supporting God at what he's doing. Now we can just say, man, I'm a child of God and I am loved. I am righteous in his sight. And I'm going to take what I have that God has given me, whatever gift God has given me, whatever God has given you. And man, I am going to support God in this matter. I am going to support God because we have been placed on this earth to support God and what he's doing. We are here on this earth to support his plan, his will, his almighty awesome plan. That's what we're here for. So now, like, this is changing everything. I mean, I am beside myself right now. Oh my goodness. Paula writes, yes, we should never wait to be led to do something. He has already told us to do and promise he has already done with the finished work at the cross. We should just do it and not wait to be led. We are commanded to go, thus saith the Lord. Matthew 28, 18 and 20. Bear with me a second. Love you, bro. Thank you. Yeah, I was just seeing a text from Tim real quick. So, wow. Any other scriptures that come to mind, obviously, feel free to post it and share it on here. I mean, this is amazing. This is going to bring just more revelation knowledge. It's going to tie in scripture. It's just going to make everything just flow even easier, that we are supporting God in this. And this is how we support one another. I'm just hearing this right now. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for that remembrance of scripture. There's a scripture, and I was looking at it earlier, and I don't know what it is right now, where the address is at. Whew. Hope that makes sense. It says that we grow from faith to faith because the righteous live by faith. So isn't it something that the righteous live by faith? So Paula, you live by faith. I live by faith. Tim, you live by faith. Ro, you live by faith. Faith White, you're on here. You live by faith. Lydia, you live by faith. And as we encourage one another, and I hear your testimonies, and you hear my testimonies, and I hear you speak, and you hear me speak, we sharpen each other. Iron sharpening iron, okay? And the sparks start flying, and your faith gets matched up to my faith, and vice versa, his faith and her faith and my faith and your faith, and all of a sudden it's faith and faith and faith and faith and faith. And this is what that scripture means, that we go from faith to faith. Because as I keep hearing Paula's testimony today, that she shared the gospel of the good news, I get inspired by Paula and her faith, and she increases now my faith. And now I take what the measure of faith God gave me, and now this measure of faith that Paula just gave me because I heard her story, I take that, and now I grow in faith, and I grow in faith, and I grow in faith. And every time we grow in faith, we grow, because we're learning the word faith is to support God, imuna. Every time we grow in faith, or every time we grow in imuna, the Hebrew word, we grow in supporting God in what he's doing. Amen. We grow in supporting God in what he's doing. You hear faith from me, and you grow in support of the mission that God's putting you on, and the mission that God's put all of us on, to go and make disciples, to go and share the good news of the gospel, to heal the sick, cast out demons, right? Cleanse the lepers, which today could be all sorts of things, you know, cleanse them from corona, heal them from coronavirus or whatever they're going through. And now when we keep hearing, faith is growing more and more inside of us, and we're taking that faith and we're supporting God in it. I mean, this is just amazing what God is showing us here. And thank you, Father God. What other scriptures are coming to mind about faith? I'm going to go ahead and read some. Got the Bible app here. So I was reading earlier, Ephesians 2:8 says this: "For by grace you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves, it is a gift of God." So for by grace you have been saved through faith. And the faith that we're saved by is obviously, isn't it something, the measure of faith that God gave us all? And then we respond with belief to that measure of faith, and we're saved through that. Amen. If there's anybody on that you don't know that you're saved, you don't have a personal relationship with God, today's your day. Today's your day, and you will receive Jesus today as your Lord and Savior. It goes on, Hebrews 11:1. "Now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the convictions of things not seen." Faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction or the evidence of things not seen. and we know that scripture quite a bit, you know, and that's why we gotta have, you see, wow. How many of you guys just saw what I just saw? Let's see. I know you guys saw this. Let's see if you saw this. Now, faith, imuna, is the assurance of things hoped for, the evidence or the conviction of things not seen. Faith, imuna, supports God. Faith supports God. And isn't it something? It's what we hope for, but the evidence or the conviction of things not seen. Not just things not seen, but none of us have seen God. Yet, with our measure of faith, we could support God because He gave us that. That is our hope. We learned it last week, hope, what hope is in Christ. And our hope is in our faith and trust in Jesus. And that the blood of the Lamb, you know, canceled out our sins. And now we can live forevermore with Jesus. Well, look at that scripture. Now, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the evidence or conviction of things not seen. We haven't seen God yet, right? One day we will, but we haven't seen God yet. But that's why our faith, emuna, supports God. Man, that is just amazing how that reads right there. Hebrews 11:3 goes on. By faith, we understand that the worlds were prepared by the word of God, so that what is seen was not made out of things which are visible. Again, God made something out of nothing. That was just God in His glory. He made the earth. And here's the scripture I wanted to read. Hebrews 11:6. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. For he who comes to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who seek Him. And without faith, imuna, it is impossible to please Him. Let's break that down. And without imuna, without faith, without imuna, without supporting God, it's impossible to please Him. Well, of course, how could you please the God of the universe when we're not even supporting His plan? We're not even supporting Him. We're not supporting His will. This is amazing. Wow. And without faith, it is impossible to please Him. For he who comes to God, us that come to God, must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who seek Him. I mean, guys, this is just phenomenal. And that's why everything hinges on our belief system. What are we believing? Are we taking God at His word, or are we taking everybody else's word of what's going on? Amen. What are you guys hearing from God right now? What are you guys hearing from Holy Spirit? What scriptures are coming to mind? Is there anything that you guys want to share? Please jot it down. Let's do this. Let's do this together. I mean, wow. Wow. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Faith. Faith. If we would have faith the size of a mustard seed, we can move. If we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we can move mountains. If we have faith, imuna, if we support God, if we have faith the size of a mustard seed, we take our faith and support God, we can move mountains. Well, of course, He's the one that moves the mountain. We got to support God. We're just tapping in our faith with His faithfulness. Wow. That kind of hope is backed up by God. Amen. See, it's all coming clear, just like my mom just said there. What kind, That kind of hope is backed up by God. So what God is saying since the beginning of time, will you take me at my word? My word is Jesus. Jesus is the truth. The truth will set you free. Whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is freedom. It is our job to run this race where Jesus left off. And Jesus left off with, "It is finished," on the cross. Died, rose again, lives, is in heaven, interceding on our behalf. His blood, his physical, manly blood is in heaven. The only man, physical man, in heaven, because he was perfect and he was from God, is crying out on the mercy seat, crying out better things of you and me. And he's interceding on our behalf while sitting on the right hand of the Father. I mean, this is beautiful what God is sharing with us today. Paula writes, John 14:12. All right, John 14:12, let's read it. And let me go to it. Thank you, Father. John 14:12, thank you, Lord. So good. All right, 14, here we go. So I'm reading out of the New American Standard Bible, and John 14:12 reads like this. Truly, truly, Jesus speaking here. Truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he will do also. And greater works than these he will do, because I go to the Father. Isn't that amazing? Yes, no worries, Paula. Just you guys pop in the scripture and I can read it, no problem. I love this scripture because truly, truly, I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, Jesus, you will also do. And greater works will you do, even as I did. Because why? Jesus says, because I go to the Father. So he's saying, I'm no longer physically with you. Spiritually, I'm with you through Holy Spirit, because Jesus says, I abide in you, you abide in me. But our connection is heavenly. How do you think we bring heaven here on earth? Because Jesus is in heaven interceding on our behalf. And it says that we are seated with him in heavenly places. Well, how can that be? Because our spirit that's inside of us is also connected to heaven, is also connected to Jesus, and that's how we can bring heaven here on earth, because Jesus is in heaven, and he's there, and we're here, physically here, but spiritually we're there, yet spiritually we're here, because spiritually we're there. And I know that might sound confusing, but that's how it is. And if we would believe it and take God at his word, and we put our faith with the Lord, and we put our faith, which we learned is imuna, which means to support God, we're putting our faith on God Almighty, and we're saying, you know what, Lord, the measure, it's not even from us, it's the measure of faith he gave us, but we're believing in that measure of faith that he gave us, and we're taking that measure of faith, and we're supporting God with that measure of faith, and we're supporting God in what he says, and we're supporting God in his plan, and his will, and what he says, and we're taking him at his word, the word of Jesus. The word of truth, amen? And we're running with this. And if he says we're righteous, we're taking him at his word, and we're saying, by golly, we are righteous. If he calls us a saint, by golly, I'm a saint. No longer a sinner. Why? He says he dealt with it. Past, present, and future. We need to get out of our own way, out of our mind, and take God at his word and believe it and run with it, because that's how we're going to run this race with endurance. We're not crawling this race of endurance. Woo! Glory to God. Yeah, Paula, I know it. We're not crawling. We're not crawling this race of endurance. No, we are running this race of endurance. You know why we're running this race of endurance? Because this race is already rigged. I think we said it a few weeks ago. This life is already rigged for us to win. He says, you are more than a conqueror. You have the victory already. The victory is mine. The victory is yours. The victory is ours. You know why? Because the victory was done on Calvary. The victory was done by the blood of the Lamb, by Jesus. And that is what's going on. And now we're just running this race with endurance. Why are we running this race? Because we're realizing, I'm just getting this right now, we're realizing that time is short. So we're running like we're running out of time, because God is outside of time. But God only gives us a maximum now of 120 years to fulfill His will, to fulfill His plan, to reach all His children, to reach all His sons and daughters, right? So let's run with Jesus. Let's run with God. Let's run with the Holy Spirit. And let's run this endurance, because we have endurance. We're not going to grow weary. He says you won't grow weary because He is with us. You will not grow weary. You will not grow weary. Just continue to rest in Him, the finished work of Jesus, and He will take you through. Amen. And I forgot to read what Lydia wrote. Faith gives authority to speak the will of God, the desires of God. He desires is in us. Amen. Faith gives us authority to speak the will of God. Yes, it gives us the authority to speak the will of God, because we just learned that faith in Hebrew means emunah, which means to support. It's an action word, taking our action of faith and supporting God. I mean, amazing. Of course we're going to support the will of God. We're taking our faith and supporting His faithfulness, His plan that He's always had. We shared this revelation, I think it was last week or the week before. He says, the earth is my footstool. God says, the earth is my footstool. What is a footstool used for? A footstool is used for, man, I'm going to kick back and relax. You know, you guys come home from work and maybe you got an ottoman, a footstool. We call them ottomans now, right? And you're just tired. You grabbed your water. You got your meal and you kick your feet up and you're like, ah, man, this is great. I can just kick back and relax. Oh, man, thank you, Father. You're so good. Thank you for this day. What are we doing? We're resting. We're resting in Him. We're resting in a finished work that we completed today, right? We went out, and in our work, we did it all for the glory of God, because we didn't do our work unto the boss. We didn't do our work to be noticed by the boss. We didn't do our work so that the boss would see us and give us a raise. We didn't do our work so somebody could pat on back and say, man, great job, brother. We didn't do our work for that. And if you did, repent from that. There's no condemnation in Christ, and I'm not spanking you. I'm just calling us up to what God is calling us up to. What He's reminding me of. Hey, don't be doing that for the boss. I'm the one watching you. You're doing this unto me. We work and we do this, and we're doing it unto the glory of the Lord. Whether we eat, drink, work, whatever we do, let's do it. It's Colossians, I think 3:17. We do it unto the glory of the Lord. So when I come home and I put my foot up on that ottoman and that footstool, I'm resting and I'm thanking God. Man, Lord, thanks for your help. Thank you for supporting me in your faithfulness, and me supporting you by living in faith and doing my work in faith, and I was doing it unto you. Thank you for teaching me how to handle that situation at work where I could have handled that wrong in the flesh, but the Holy Spirit quickened in me and said, no, stay quiet here, do this. You know, thank you, Lord, that you taught me that today at work, and you taught that. And I'm just going through you guys an example for all of us as our work day. Oops, sorry. Of a possible work day. And then we get home and we put our foot up on that ottoman, on that footstool. And we say, thank you, Lord. And what are we doing? We're resting in a finished work. We're resting in, wow, what a great day, Lord. It was beautiful. Well, guess what? Now let's take that in a bigger scope, a bigger picture. Zoom out. and you see God, and he says, the earth is my footstool. And on the seventh day, God rested from his works. Ever since the beginning of the foundations of the earth, when he spoke the world into existence and spoke light and spoke all these things, right, that we see. And on the seventh day, he rested. He saw that everything was good all those 6 days. Follow me here. All those 6 days, he saw it was good. It was good, and it was good. And God saw 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 it was good. And oh, yeah, God saw it was good. God made mankind, and yes, he saw that it was good. He was glad to make man in his image and likeness, in the image of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And he saw that it was good. And on the seventh day, God rested and put his foot on that footstool, the footstool of earth. And if you can see my legs kicking back, God rested his feet on that footstool that he calls earth. And he said, now let me sit back and watch my children. I'm just gonna love on my children. I know every hair on their head. I love them so much. Oh my God, look at my children. I'm just gonna rest from my finished work because everything that's gonna happen has already been spoken. What's that scripture in Isaiah? For I have a hope and a plan and a future for you. It's already been spoken, and God is just sitting back resting. Because everything that was ever going to be done is done. Even Jesus was done. We can't fathom it because God is outside of time. But in his scripture, in his word, it says that Jesus was slain. The Lamb of God was slain before the foundations of the earth. It was all spoken. And the Spirit of God was hovering upon the waters. God spoke, and it was. Everything that he spoke, and it was, all in 6 days. And ever since then, he's been resting. I'm staying on here long about the rest and what God is doing, because it is a foreshadow of what we need to do now. Because now that Jesus did all the heavy lifting, come on, somebody shout hallelujah, somebody say amen. Now that Jesus did all the heavy lifting, now that he lived out perfection as a man, by the way, because he laid aside his deity, he came as a man, walked this out with the power of Holy Spirit, living with Holy Spirit every day, not living by the desires of the flesh, but living by the Spirit. And every day walking by the Spirit and staying in tune to the Spirit. And Jesus used his faith, his emunah, to support his Father, to support God in his will, because it's God's master plan, it's God's will. And Jesus used his faith to support emunah, support God in God's faithfulness, and Jesus saw it through. Jesus saw it through, and now Jesus said, it is finished. And he's telling us, the children of God, us, all the sons and daughters of God, will you now rest in me? Jesus said, abide in me as I abide in you. Jesus is sitting at the right hand of the Father. So the Father is sitting there. The earth is his footstool, and Jesus is right next to him. Amen. Jesus is right next to him, resting, interceding on our behalf. And now if Jesus is abiding in us and we in him, how much more should we be resting in the finished work of Jesus? How much more should we be resting in what God already said is good, and God's been resting since that seventh day? How much more? What's up, Jacqueline? I'm glad you made it. Definitely go back and watch the other parts. God is speaking. Holy Spirit is reminding us of Scripture, and we are all getting equipped as His saints and His lovers, and He is just, He's awesome. And Jesus is saying, rest in my finished works, whom the Son sets free, Jesus, whom Jesus has set free, is free indeed. Jesus has set the captives free, so let us all run free. Let us run this race of endurance. So have our faith support God and just match our faith with God and say, Lord, I'm going to use the measure of faith you gave me. I'm going to support your will and I'm going to run this race because time is short. We only have a maximum of 120 years and I'm going to rest in your peace and I'm going to rest in who you are. I'm going to rest in what you said. I'm going to rest in your promises. I'm going to rest in yes and amen. I am going to rest in the finished work of Christ Jesus. Now, does that mean that we don't have things to do? No, we have things to do. He already gave us things to do. He said, go and make disciples. Go and share the good news of the gospel. Go out two by two, share the good news. Go out and lay hands on the sick. Go out and cast out devils, cast out demons, for I am with you. But rest in me, it's no longer you doing the work, for I have accomplished the work. I have accomplished the work. We just take our faith and support God's faithfulness and just match our faith with His, and He does the work. It's already done. He just wants us to step out in faith, rest in the finished work, and watch Him do what He's gonna do. But let us believe in Him and let's just do it and run with Him. Absolutely. Charles, he's saying something here. I'm glad I gotta switch hands here. I'm glad to join this. I need prayers. All right, Charles. We will be praying for you, brother. What else did everybody write here? Hold on, Charles. I'll get back to you in just a sec. Lydia wrote, when I went through the issue of my son, the season of constant worries, the Lord said to me to rest in His peace. How can He work His best? He works His best works when I'm not resting. Oh, okay. He can. He works His best works when I'm not resting in His peace. Faith, I'm not seeing the rest of it. Faith, peace, and rest. Amen. So glad that you were obedient to Him and His words there, Lydia. Amazing. And sometimes we don't always get it on the first shot. I know I haven't, and I've been disobedient plenty of times and not listened to the Lord. Amen. Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father. Yes, Lord, help us as the church to spread the good news. Thank you, Father. And Lydia also says, and God has been faithful. My son is still around and God is still working. Yes, Father, we give you all glory and praise for what you're doing in Lydia and Lydia's son. We thank you that you are drawing closer to him, Lord. Send people to Lydia's son, Father God. Send people that would pour into him and speak life. You know, some of us sow seed, some of us water, but Lord, you bring the increase. Father God, we know you will bring the increase, but we also want you to send more saints, send more men and women of God that know who they are in you, and they stand in righteousness, and they call into her son who he is, that they speak life into who he is. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, Charles. Charles, you're needing prayers. Is there anything specific, Charles? Let us know. Paul, Matthew 28, 18 through 20. Our mandate is not optional. Have faith in what he has said to do. Last verse is key. I will read it. Matthew 18, 19 through 20. Okay, let's go check it out. Let's go check it out. Matthew. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Whoa. Where did that scripture go? Hold on. Bear with me here. Having a tough time. My mouse is acting up. There's Matthew. Okay. Yep. Thank you guys for sharing and being engaged with everything here. This is awesome. Love it. Love all, everything everybody's writing. Man, the first thing that Matthew 28 on the top of the chapter for Matthew 28, it says, Jesus is risen! Exclamation point. Oh, yes, he is. Jesus is risen. All right, 18 through 20. And Jesus came up and spoke to them, saying, all authority has been given to me in heaven and on earth. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, all people, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I commanded you. And lo, I am with you always, even to the end of the age. That is awesome. Yes, that's a great reminder. And thank you, Paula. Alana, what is up? Alana is here to join us. I met Alana at a neighborhood Walmart, and God used me to speak into her life, and it was awesome. It was awesome, and praise God for her, and her daughter just graduated. So, Alana, thanks for being on here. All right, Charles wrote, I need God to intervene in my home and bind the spirit of miscarriage, and barrenness in my home. Wow. All right, saints, you have heard. You have heard the request from Charles. Let's lift Charles up right now. Start interceding on his behalf in the spirit. Start speaking in tongues. If you step out in faith with your spiritual language, go ahead and start doing that at home. We are going to pray for Charles that he has breakthrough in his home. And if anybody has a word for him, place it in the comments for Charles. If the Holy Spirit is speaking to you specifically and has a word, place it in the comments so Charles can see it. I will pray here in a minute, just as you all intercede on his behalf, on Charles' behalf, on our brother's behalf, and our sister's behalf, his wife. And we thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Father. I'm waiting for you, Holy Spirit. I'm waiting for you, Holy Spirit. And don't be alarmed. Speaking in tongues is just a spiritual language. It's in the scriptures, it talks about that tongues will be spoken, especially when you get baptized in the Holy Spirit by Father, Son, Holy Spirit, and you're baptized in His love, that you will have a spiritual language that you can communicate to God with. And tongues is just this. It's a spiritual language that you will grow in by faith. And you just open your mouth and see what the Spirit is saying. And a lot of times the Spirit, it says the Spirit is groaning. And sometimes we don't know what to pray for. So the Spirit will groan deep inside of you. And the Spirit will groan. And in the Spirit, it will utter tongues. And in those tongues, it's edifying your spirit. And so you may not have an interpretation for that. And it's okay. And somebody else may not have an interpretation. Sometimes speaking in tongues, and this is scriptural, you'll see it. Once I know the address, I'll send it to you guys. But it says that the Spirit groans and it edifies you. So sometimes that groaning is edifying you and it's building you up because you just don't know what to say, you don't know what to do, and that Spirit is testifying for you. It's testifying the blood of Jesus for you by speaking in tongues, and it's building you up. And next thing you know, in that build up, now you have some words or something to go off of. Amen. You have something to stand by. So Father God, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Father God, we just thank you, Lord. We thank you for the boldness of Charles, that he knows who he is in you, Lord, that him and his wife know who they are in you, Lord, that he knows your plans, that you have a hope and a plan and a future for their life. And he knows what the word of God says. And he is taking you at your word just like we talked about earlier, he is taking you at your word. Your word is Jesus, and your promises are yes and amen. And Father God, you told us to multiply the earth. Father God, whatever is going on there with the barrenness and in the womb, Father God, we speak against it right now in Jesus' name, and not just me. Woo! But the saints that are listening right now, the brothers and sisters that are on here right now, they are putting their faith. Man, wow, Lord, you are using this faith that you just taught us, and we're doing it right now, and we spoke on this. You are amazing, Father. You are amazing. We talked about our faith growing with one another's faith, and this is what's going to happen right now, because everybody's faith is joined in right now, and they're speaking in tongues, and they're praying right now, Father God, and everybody's emunah, the Hebrew word faith, emunah, is supporting you, Lord, is supporting you. So we're taking our faith and our prayers, and we're supporting God, and we're saying, Father, it is in your word. Father, you said we are to multiply the earth. It is you that said Charles and his wife will have kids. Charles, you are to place your seed into her womb, and that seed is to grow, thus saith the Lord, because it is God's will. We are taking our faith and supporting God's plan. And God has already spoken, children, in Charles and his wife's life. So God, we are taking you at your word, and we're taking our faith, and we're supporting for what you said. That's all we're doing, is we're taking our faith and putting it back to your faithfulness, Lord. Your faithfulness, Father God, that Charles and his wife will have kids, Father God, and that no longer will she be barren, no longer will her womb be empty, but Father God, you will place the child in there. You will place the child in there, Father God, in Jesus' name. And all the saints say, amen. Life, yes. Amen. Yes. Yes. Thank you. Touch the womb. Yes. Thank you, God. Man, wow. We bind the spirit of depression in Jesus' name. Beauty for ashes. Thank you, Paula, for that. Speak life in the belly of your bride. Wow. You guys are awesome. Praise God. Man, this is so encouraging. You guys are awesome. You guys are awesome. Thank you, Lord. Lord, you have heard the saints. You have heard your children. You have heard the sons and daughters of you, Lord. We are just taking you at your word, and we are running after this, Lord. We are running after this. We are taking our faith and supporting our brother Charles. Yes, we love you, Charles. We love you, Charles. We love you, Charles, and we know you'll continue to be on and follow us, and we are going to hear a testimony from Charles and his wife, and we're going to hear a testimony of when that happens, and he's going to share, and one day we'll have Charles live on this video sharing the good news of what God has done in his life. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Man, I wanna you know, share briefly something before we head out. Already gone a little longer. Well, not that I had a time limit, but I just want to speak to the spirit of rejection, the spirit of abandonment, the spirit of I'm not good enough. The spirit of condemnation and shame. I want to speak against this right now. Because it says in his word that there is no condemnation in those that are in Christ Jesus. So earlier in this week, I failed my wife. And I didn't respond in love to her on Wednesday night. And for those few moments, for those few minutes, you know, I responded out of the flesh instead of the spirit. And in those few moments, you know, I hurt my wife, you know, emotionally, and I hurt her because I didn't speak to her on a spiritual level, and I responded out of the flesh. I've obviously apologized to her, asked for forgiveness immediately I was talking to the Lord about it as well. And I know with the Father everything was fine. But I want to speak to this for everybody too, because I'm just being transparent with you guys with it, because I know there's no guilt and shame or condemnation in Christ, and that's the key. It's in Christ. So when then I turn to Christ and I say, Lord, I messed up those 2 minutes. I wish I could take them back, Father. You know, I didn't respond out of love. I didn't love her like you love the church and how you love her as a daughter. And Father, forgive me. And I knew he forgave me. And I said, thank you for forgiving me. Lord, help me in my moments of weakness, be my strength. And man, a few days later, him and I had this amazing, powerful prayer. I just felt the Spirit of God come upon me, and he showed me how I would respond next time if I was in the same situation, and how I would respond. And it was beautiful, and I just claimed it, and I spoke it with my mouth, and I said, that's how it's gonna be, Lord, and that's how I will respond, and I will respond in that way, and I will respond in love. And if I'm not able to at that moment, and the flesh is trying to rise up, then I will remove myself from the equation, Lord. Not because I love her less, but I love her so much that I don't want to hurt her, that I will back away for a moment, for a brief moment, and I would be quick to listen and slow to speak. And it was just this powerful prayer, and I just saw a vision of next time and my response in the Spirit. And it was just a beautiful thing, because this is how God wants us to be. You know, when if I'm not transparent, and if I'm not honest with myself, not that I had to tell you guys anything, but if I wasn't honest with myself and with the Lord already sees everything. But if I'm not honest with myself, then I'm not going to have healing in those areas. I'm not going to have victory in those areas. I'm not going to have the peace of God come over me. And I felt no guilt, no shame, no condemnation. Why? Because I immediately turned to Christ, and he washed it all away. He reminded me I paid for that too. Yep, even those 2 minutes right there, those moments of weakness, I paid for that. And it was this just overwhelming thank you to Jesus. And of course I was sorry that I hurt my wife and, you know, hurt her emotionally and scared her. And of course, you know, and she knows my heart, and she knows where I stand. But it doesn't take away the hurt that I gave her at that moment. Now, obviously, she takes that to God and you know, pours that out to him. You know, she can only do what she can do as far as that goes, as far as, you know, giving any kind of hurts to the Lord, just like I had to do the same thing. And in that, man, I'm just sharing a testimony, because in doing so, I'm able to come on here and still equip the saints. Not out of performance, but out of love. Out of loving you. Out of loving my neighbor as I love myself. Out of loving even my wife, even in a moment of weakness. And I'm speaking on this, and I just feel it strongly from the Lord. Is just because you have a moment of weakness or living out of the flesh doesn't mean you have to run away from God and hide for a day, or hide for 2 days, or hide for a week. Thank you, Father. You don't have to hide. He sees it all. He wants us to have a heart after David. Like David, have a heart after God. David had a heart after God. And that's all he's asking us, is to have a heart after God. Because if we have a heart after God, when those situations arise, we can turn to God and say, Lord, I messed up. Lord, forgive me. And then immediately you turn it. Lord, thank you for forgiving me. Thank you for your grace. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your forgiveness. Thank you for your love. And he honors it immediately. And he says, I don't even see that sin anymore. I don't even see it anymore. And yeah, you might have some repercussions to deal with the hurt that you caused the other person, and you might have some consequences, but God is faithful, and God is looking at you and is, well done. Thank you for having a soft heart. Thank you for coming back and throwing it right at me, because I don't see it anymore. And I'm telling you, sons and daughters of God, whatever you're going through, give it to Him. Surrender it to Him. The peace of God will come upon you, and this is how we rest in Him. This is how I can rest in Him. Why? Because I know I can take God at His word and say, you know, wait a second, I'm putting my faith not in me, because if I put my faith in me, I'll fail me and others around me every single time. But if I put my faith in God, if I put my faith in Muna, my support, my faith, my support in God, then He will carry me through, because my support is in Him, not in me. Because if it was in me, it would be nonsense, and I would fail every single time. But when I put my faith in the King, when I put my faith in my Lord, when I put my faith in Him, Imuna, and I support what He says, then I can give it to Him, and He can take that offering and say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Thankful for keeping a soft heart. There is no guilt, no shame, no condemnation in those that are in Christ Jesus. And then the rest comes upon me, you know, though I was resting, but more rest, more peace. And you could be like, wow, you're amazing, Lord, because I don't deserve it. Yet you do it because it's your word. You cannot deny yourself. And that's the beauty, guys. The Lord, God cannot deny Himself. So He said it. He's waiting for us to rest in what He said, to take Him at His word, the word of Jesus. Take Him at His word, believe it. Yes and amen. And when we do, we can rest in that, because He cannot deny Himself. He's just looking for those that are willing to have a soft heart, that no longer, the heart that God took out when we came to Him, the stony heart was replaced by the heart of flesh. But it only stays that way if we keep surrendering us to Him. And when we mess up, we surrender it to Him, and we repent with an honest heart, and we repent, and He keeps our hearts soft. Amen. And it's so good. Let me read what you guys wrote. Thank you, Lord. Lydia, testimony means repetition. He'll do it again. We needed your testimony. I know I did. Rejection is my constant flaw and anger of my constant rejection. Thank you. Yes. Thank you, Lydia, for that. There it is again, Lord. Thank you, Father God. You said that we would grow from faith to faith. When we hear each other's testimony and we hear each other's faith, then we grow in faith. So Lydia can support my faith with her faith, and I can support her faith with my faith, and we can take all of our faiths and support God and what He says, and He will get us through, because He is a faithful God. Faith is emuna in Hebrew. Paula writes, the Lord's conviction is always good. Bless you for sharing, Tony. So beautiful. Thank you, Father. We aren't worthy, but He is faithful. Amen. Thank you. Thank you, Paula. Lydia, enemy fighting hard on that distraction and division, but we are saturated in the Lord, covered in His covering, praying for you and Evelyn. Thank you, Lydia. I appreciate that. And yes, it's God actually shared with me. I'm being reminded. I actually forgot, and I'm being reminded as soon as you said that I would have to look back in my notes, but the Lord shared with me about maybe four to five years ago. He shared that there is an attack on marriages right now. There always has been, but there's been a very, very strong attack on marriages, because marriage is of God. Marriage is the ultimate representation of us and the Lord. He says that we are the blameless and spotless bride, and He is our groom. That is marriage. And so marriage, physical marriage here on earth, is that representation of our marriage with Him. So the enemy wants to come against all marriages, because by coming against the physical marriage, he's coming against the sons and daughters of God. He's coming against marriage of Jesus, the groom, and us, the blameless, spotless bride. And I'm seeing this right now. Thank you, Father, for sharing. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Holy Spirit. The same way we are the blameless, spotless bride that our groom is coming for. Wow. The same way the blameless, spotless bride that our Jesus is coming for, the body of Christ, all of us. That is the same way us husbands, I'm talking to us husbands continue to look at our wives as blameless and spotless. Even if they are not, we see them how God sees them, blameless and spotless. And we call into and pour into them who they are, who God sees them to be. The perspective of love, the perspective of God is always love. And He says, husbands, love your wives as Christ loves the church. And what I'm seeing so clear, if Jesus, the groom, is coming for a blameless, spotless bride, then husbands, we need to see our wives as the blameless, spotless bride. Even through the rejection, abandonment, rejection issues, whatever issues is going on, whatever times of operating out of the flesh, men walk in the Spirit, live in the Spirit, speak in the Spirit to our wives and see them blameless and spotless. That was the Lord. Thank you, Lydia. All glory to God. All glory to God. All glory to God. He just gave me another one. Thank you, Father, for that reminder. Somebody's going to have to find the scripture, but it's Ezekiel. You guys know it. I want to say Ezekiel 28, but it's not coming to me right now. Thank you, Father. Speak life into the dry bones. Husbands, speak life into the dry bones of your wives. Speak life into the dry bones, and sinew will go on sinew, and ligament to ligament, and bone to bone, and the spirit will come alive, and the blameless, spotless bride that is in there will come alive. And women, I'm speaking to you now. Thank you, Father. It is time to lay down how you view yourself. The view you have of yourself is through the lens of the flesh and not the lens of the Spirit. Thus saith the Lord. Jesus. Jesus. Lay down rejection. Lay down pride. Lay down abandonment. Lay down all the enemy's lies that have been attacking your mind. Women, God is going to use every daughter of the King in such a mighty way in this time. Okay, Lord. You know how He wanted me to go? It's beautiful. Receive it. women let go. Okay, yes, Lord. He says, he goes, use the analogy of the bathroom. Men go to the bathroom, and we could be talking on the outside, and we go from the outside, and we go, and we're talking, yeah, let me use Charles as an example. Yeah, what's up, Charles? Man, oh, man, God's doing this, God's doing that. Man, thank God. Yeah, I know. And it's, oh, yeah, yeah. And as soon as we're going in the bathroom, we shut up, and we go do our business, and we keep a face to the wall, look at the brick, right? And we pee, we do our business, and we out, wash our hands, and we out, and we continue our conversation. You women, on the other hand, you go to the bathroom and you speak, oh, yeah, I know. Yeah, can you give me some toilet paper underneath the stall? Yeah, yeah, here you go, girl. Yeah, and it's, oh, man, praise God. Yeah, you know what so-and-so did? I don't know. Yeah, tell me about it. Yeah, this, yeah, that. And on and on and on, even before that. Hey, girl, you want to go to the bathroom? Yeah, let's go to the bathroom, girl. Come on. They go to the bathroom and they speak, right? God wanted me to share that and have a little laugh for a minute and then bring it back to what God is doing. Because He wants us to see something here. Because women, the same way you are like that and you speak, and sometimes you can get caught up. We all get caught up in this, but I'm just speaking to the women at the moment. Sometimes we can get caught up in gossiping, talking down on somebody. Saying, yeah, I can't believe that girl, blah, 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 and they keep going and going and going, and we just kind of attack that. So now look at the spirit side of that, what's going to happen. And here's what I'm seeing. As the Lord was talking about, now tie in the bathroom scene and the speaking and thinking and how we think ourselves. Now let's go back to what we were talking about. Women of God, it's time to lay down every identity issue, every identity crisis that you have had in your mind. The battlefield of the mind, the enemy is attacking you in your mind, because there is something inside of you. It's from the Spirit of God, and God has something specific for every single woman. And women, you have a vital role in this end times that we're living in. You have a vital role. Jesus, yes, Lord, thus saith the Lord, your role, because, need some lipstick, sister, your role is to speak life. But you can't speak life all the time if in the flesh you're having all this battle of rejection and this battle of abandonment and this battle of I'm not worthy and this battle I'm not good enough and this battle of, man, I get angry so many times and this battle of, man, I worry and I battle with this and I battle with that. It is time to lay down the lies of the enemy. That is the enemy's lies. He is the father of lies, and all he speaks is lies. If anything that comes into your mind is not producing fruit, then it is death and it is a lie from the father of lies. You belong to the father of light, and the father of light is the father of life, and the father of life produces fruit inside of you, the nine fruits of the Spirit, and He speaks life into you. And from your life that He's speaking into you, that life you will speak into others. It's time to lay down all of the lies. Women, lay down the lies. Start seeing how God sees you. And men, husbands, let us pour into our wives how God sees them. It is, the scripture says, by the showering of the word of God is how we will speak into our wives. We will shower the word of God. Speak life into our wives. So the lies will be destroyed. It's the enemy's strategy of deception to keep you there. Women, receive this word, believe this word, take God at His word, because he wants to use all the daughters of the king mightily. He's going to use you the same way you girls talk in the bathroom. You're going to lift each other up constantly. You're going to speak life into situations constantly. You won't gossip about this girl or that girl, or I can't believe they did this, or can't believe they did that. Instead, you're going to say, what? So-and-so said that? Let's lift them up in prayer immediately. You're not going to need the details of well, tell me what happened about this. No, you're going to go to the Lord and go on their behalf and say, let's battle this. This is a spiritual warfare. Let's battle this right now in Jesus' name. Let's battle this. Wow. And that's what you ladies are gonna do, and you're gonna speak life, and in speaking life, I mean, it's just gonna be beautiful, because in that you girls are just gonna run with the Lord. You're gonna take God at His word for everything that He says, and it's, I just see it, and I just had to share it, and that's the best way how it came upon me. I could share it to you guys and give you that with the bathroom scene, but receive it, take it, run with it, because God is calling. It says that every single one of us, husbands and wives, single, not single, sons and daughters of God, God is saying this: you are righteous in my sight. I call you blameless. You are saints. You are not sinners. Confess your sins to me. They're forgiven. But keep the soft heart to me and confess them. Love me like David loved me, right? Repent is a big one. Repentance. Turn back to God. Change the way you think on the matter. Repentance. Okay, women and men, I'm being reminded. Repentance, change the way you think. In Greek, it means metanoia, means change the way you think. So no longer think from the ways of the enemy's lies and his strategies, but now start renewing the mind. What is it? We are no longer conformed to the patterns of this world, but we are now transformed by the renewing of our mind. How do we renew our mind? It's by repentance, changing the way we think. So let us all, sons and daughters of God, change the way we think on that. You are no longer a sinner. You are a saint. You are righteous in His sight. You are blameless in His sight. And even when we fail, bring it to Him with your soft heart, repent from it. He'll teach you, He'll show you, and grow from that. Just move on and grow from that, okay? That's what I see, and I just wanted to share that. Wow, we've gone long. I want to use one more analogy with that real quick before we wrap up. Paula writes, so people won't think Tony's hallucinating, I wrote, need some lipstick sixer, removed it because thought it might be viewed as fleshy, but in the ladies' room. No, I knew what you meant. You were fine. You were good. You're good. I got you, girl. Man, that was amazing. And that's what I was going to say about the sin, or maybe not seeing us righteous sometimes at times. The last thing I wanted to leave you with is, think of kids playing in the playground, and one of the kids gets sand in their eyes, and let's just say the sand in their eyes is the sin. They messed up, you know, they didn't do what they were supposed to. They lived out of the flesh instead of the spirit. They said something out of the flesh instead of the spirit, and now they've got sand in their eyes. And the first instinct in the flesh, you know, when we have sand in our eyes, is to kind of rub it out. Oh man, I got to get this out of here. I got to get this out of here. And we're crying and we're crying. Oh my gosh. And we're just making it worse and worse and worse. And instead of complaining about the sin and looking at how we messed up and how we're sinners and how, you know, I'm a failure and I'm a this and all these negative thoughts, instead of doing that and rubbing that in our eyes and just sitting there pouting and crying, Jesus is waiting for us right there. He's in the swings and He's saying, come on, guys, come on, my brothers, my sisters, it's okay. Confess it. Confess it with your heart. Repent from it. Come to me. I love you. I forgive you. Hop back on this swing. This swing is a representation of our walk in Christ. Hop back on. There is no condemnation in Christ Jesus. There's no guilt, no shame, no condemnation in those in Christ Jesus. And he's coming over like this. Come on, guys. Jump on the swing. We got a good fight of faith.
to keep on going. We have to keep running this race of endurance. We got to keep on going. So let's not rub that sin in our eyes, that sand in our eyes, and irritate it and just stay there and run away from God from a day, for an hour, for a day, for 2 days, for a week, for a month. No, let's confess it. Let's realize what we did, and let's say, Lord, thank you for teaching me. Thank you for loving me. Let's move on. Let's grow from this. Thank you, Father God. And he's there on the swing saying, thank you, son. Thank you, daughter. Let's do this together. And that's it, guys. He loves us. Let's run with it. I know you were encouraged. I was encouraged. Thank you for everything you guys shared on here. Thank you for encouraging each other. Thank you, Charles, for sharing. Everybody that shared such amazing words. I am encouraged. I am lifted. I am loved. You guys are encouraged. You guys are lifted, and you are loved. And man, we are saints. Let's run this race. Run it. Let's not crawl. Let's run it. And even those around us that maybe are not running, let's continue to spur them on and keep them going. We're not looking down on nobody. We're just trying to lift everybody up and encourage everybody. Elena. Elena, it was awesome seeing you, sis. Thank you for stopping by and joining on. I hope we see you again. And this is it. You got on here, and I'm glad you're able to join in, Elena. It's so good. Maybe I'll see you later this week, all right, girl? And I'll give you a big hug, all right? So God bless you, sis. Love you. We'll share that testimony maybe on another day of how Elena and I met. So God bless you, girl. And Charles just puts Ephesians 2, 4, and 5. So let me read that real quick. Ephesians 2, 4, and 5, and then I'll shut her down for the night. Man, Lydia, you ain't kidding. Holy Spirit sure did. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Holy Spirit. He always does. So Ephesians 4, 5, he said, but God, being rich in mercy, because of his great love with which he loved us, even when we were dead in our transgressions, our sins, made us alive together with Christ. By grace, you have been saved. Wow. And then it goes on that scripture that we said earlier, and raised us up with him and seated us with him in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, so that in the ages to come he might show the surpassing riches of his grace in kindness towards us in Christ Jesus. For by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourself. It is a gift of God. So awesome. Charles, that was a great scripture. Thanks for sharing that. God bless you guys. I love you. We'll do it again next week. God bless. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you for that healing. Thank you for that rest. God bless you all. Jesus, the blood of Jesus.